We'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, to my shadow.
Weird that I can hear whatever music you play.
That's the test the sound.
Sleep till I come home. Dream of something sweet. I won't be there soon to wake you so discreet.
All right. Good afternoon, admitted Spartans. Welcome to this webcast, web seminar of the HNA Student Success Center. We are a team of dedicated professionals here to help you out throughout your academic time here at San Jose State, whether that be trying to figure out what the next stage is after college, whether that be what the next stages are during your time in college, and all of these related things. My name is Richard. I am a part of this team of advisors. We will be taking some time to introduce ourselves. The first person that I would like to introduce will be coming up shortly. Just to go over what we will be doing here today, we are going to introduce you to the team. We're going to talk about how academic advising works at San Jose State. In addition, we'll also be talking about how our service, how our center provides services to help you out, resources to help you out during your time here at San Jose State, about our center, a little bit more about our services, our hours, some time to answer your questions, and also just some tips to help you out with whatever it is you might find helpful throughout your time, wherever you go, whether that would be San Jose State, anywhere else, and also later on in life. So let's go ahead and start to introduce the team. The first person that I have the privilege of introducing is our director, Darlene Guerrero. Darlene, if you could lead off by telling us a little bit about yourself, the education path you came to be where you are right now, as well as a fun fact.
Thank you, Richard. Hi, everyone. Again, I want to welcome and congratulate you on your admissions to SJSU. My name is Darlene Guerrero, and I'm the director of the HNA Student Success Center. I am so excited that you all are here today. Thank you for taking the time to join us. Before I go into my introduction, just a quick announcement. As Richard said, we're going to be providing a quick overview of the college and our services. We're going to go right into a live Q&A in which we'll try to answer a lot of your questions, as many questions as we can live. But just in the interest of time, we want to let you know from the beginning that while this is a time of great uncertainty, we're really going to focus our responses, our live responses, to just the ones that pertain to topics related to our areas of expertise within the university, the college, or advising itself. So with that, I'll jump into my quick introduction. Again, I'm Darlene. I grew up in the Bay Area. I went to a local high school here in San Jose, and I earned both my bachelor's and master's here at San Jose State. I have a bachelor's in speech communication with a minor in business, as well as a master's in education with a focus in counseling. I enjoyed SJSU so much that I continued to come to campus every day since I graduated from my master's program. Obviously, I didn't stay as a student. I started my academic advising career at San Jose State. I originally was with the College of Business. I served as an advisor there for about 10 years. And then in 2015, the HNA Student Success Center popped up, and I joined them within their first year of their existence. In about 2 years from me starting there, I took on the director role, and since then I have had the greatest time just working more closely with professional advisors who are just as passionate as I am about helping students succeed in this environment. Fun fact about me is that with the pandemic and the limited activities, I typically like to play basketball and yoga, but all of those have stopped. And online yoga is not as enjoyable for me, so I had to pick up a new hobby. So my fun fact for today is I picked up walking, and I started tracking it in the beginning of the month. And so far, I have walked 90 miles since April 1st. Killing it. Back to you, Richard.
Okay. Thank you very much, Darlene. So a little bit about... a little bit more about Darlene is that she is the director. She is one of the people you will see in the front lines helping you guys out. She will be seeing students. So you will see her throughout your time here at San Jose State. The next person I would like to introduce is Sandy Ho, our career advisor, our academic advisor and career specialist.
All right. Welcome everyone to San Jose State, virtually, of course. My name is Sandy, and I am an academic advisor and career specialist with the HNA Student Success Center. I was born and raised here in San Jose. I ventured down to Southern California to UCSD to obtain my bachelor's in psychology, and then I made my way up to Central California to Fresno and obtained my master's in counseling at Fresno State. And now I am back home in San Jose. So fun fact about me is I love potatoes as well as boba. So if you're into any of those, I think we are going to have a terrific working relationship. So that's a little bit more about me, and I am really looking forward to get to know you more.
Thank you very much, Sandy. My video, there we go. Thank you very much, Sandy. The next person up I'd like to introduce is Lauren Welch.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lauren Welch. I'm originally from Sanger, California, so the Central Valley, and I earned my bachelor's in psychology with minors in classics and education at UC Santa Barbara before earning my master's in student affairs and college counseling from Fresno State. I've been an academic advisor and the graduation data specialist with HNA Student Success Center since this past January. And my fun fact is that because I'm such a big Harry Potter fan, my favorite first date actually took place at the Wizarding World in Universal Studios. And the person that took me there just happens now to be my fiance.
Thank you very much, Lauren. The next person I'd like you all to meet is me. My name is Richard. I am an academic advisor at the Humanities and Arts Student Success Center. I started at San Jose State in 2012 as an undergrad. I finished my undergraduate degree in linguistics. If you want to know what that is, take a class in linguistics. I'm also a grad student right now. Currently, I'm slated to finish sometime next year, spring or fall, not entirely sure. Fun fact about me is that my major advisor during my undergraduate years became my graduate advisor. And then after that, when I was hired as the as an advisor at the HNA Student Success Center, she became the associate dean of our college. So now she is my boss's boss. So it's funny how those things work. So that's enough about me. The next person I'd like to introduce is Rania Hilai-Hill.
Hello and welcome, everyone. My name is Rania Hilai-Hill. I was born and raised in Lebanon. I moved to the U.S. in August 2011 to pursue my graduate studies at the University of San Francisco. I have two master's degrees, one in education and leadership with a focus on higher education and student affairs, and the other one is in digital technologies for teaching and learning. This September will mark my second year at the HNA Student Success Center. So fun fact about me is that I had no idea what my career would be when I was an undergraduate student. But when I graduated and the career path that I took and different jobs and life experiences, especially my graduate education, led me to this job that I have and the career that I'm very passionate about. I think that's it for me. I look forward to welcoming you in person, hopefully very soon.
Thank you, Rania. Next person I'd like to introduce is Stephanie Garcia.
Hello, everyone. Hello, future Spartans. My name is Stephanie Garcia. I was born and raised in San Jose, California. I'm a two-time graduate of San Jose State. My BA was in liberal studies, prep for teaching, and my MA was in education. I've been working in the HNA Success Center for about 3 years now. And prior to that, I was working in the design office at San Jose State. Fun fact about me is that I recently proposed to my girlfriend at Disneyland, and I think that was the most nervous I've ever been in my life. So thank you guys for being here, and hopefully we'll be able to help you with the questions that you have. So.
Thank you very much, Steph. The next person I would like to introduce is Tamara Goldie.
Hello, future Spartans. My name is Tamara Goldie, and I was born and raised in the San Fernando Valley, which is down south in LA County. I earned my bachelor's in psychology from California State University, Northridge, and then I moved to the Bay Area in 1993. I then proceeded to earn my master's degree in educational psychology with an emphasis from counseling from CSU East Bay. And I've been working as an academic advisor at San Jose State for the last 15 years. Fun fact about me is I love to hike around all the local parks in Santa Clara County. I'm very familiar with all the trails. So if you have a question about where to hike, you can always pop in and see me. And hopefully our paths may cross one day on the trails. Look forward to meeting with you.
Thank you very much, Tamara. Next person, and as we go along here now, these are our support staff, administrative staff, as well as our excellent staff of students that help us out day to day. The first person I would like to introduce you to is Guadalupe Pale. She is our administrative support coordinator.
Thank you for joining us today. Allow me to extend a warm welcome. My name is Guadalupe Pale. I am the admin coordinator for the HNDA Student Success Center. I was born in Ciudad Juarez, Chihuahua, Mexico, and I grew up in downtown San Jose. A fun fact about me is my deep passion for all things Mexican. Thank you.
Thank you, Mama Lupe. We call her Mama Lupe. Next up are our peer mentors. I'm going to start it off with Wyatt. Wyatt is a peer mentor who's been here for a long time, and I will give him the opportunity to introduce himself.
Hey, Richard, thanks very much. My name is Wyatt Holtkamp. I'm currently a peer mentor here at the Humanities and Arts Student Success Center. I've been working there for probably about 3.5 years. I was born originally in Virginia and probably spent most of my formative years in Southern California, San Diego. I just graduated from San Jose State in the fall with my BM professional technical degree in music education, and will soon be starting in the credential program. I'm probably going to keep working here for a couple more months, but I hope to be able to assist you for as long as I can.
Thanks, Wyatt. And to lead off, we have another peer mentor. Their name is Nigel Fung. I will give them an opportunity to introduce themselves.
Thank you, Richard. Thanks, everybody, for joining today. My name is Nigel Fung. I'm from Thousand Oaks, California. It's a part of Southern California, close to Los Angeles. I'm an international business student focusing on a concentration in Chinese language. My position, as you were told earlier, is peer mentor at the HNA Student Success Center, and I've been here for approximately almost 2 years. A fun fact about me is that I'm originally from West Virginia, and I love to play and sing guitar. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Nigel. So those are our peer mentors, and we'll get into what a peer mentor is in just a little bit. Some of you guys may be interested after listening to this, becoming one a little bit later in the future. That's something for you to decide. Next up, we have our excellent administrative student assistants. We'll start off with Austin, and I'll give him an opportunity to introduce himself.
All right. Hi, everyone. My name is Austin Floresca. From one student to another, I'd like to welcome you to SCSU. So I'm originally from Fairfield, California, but I'm currently a sophomore at SCSU, and I'm working towards a business marketing degree as of right now. I have been a student assistant for about half a year now, and my fun fact is that I actually produce music a lot more now since everything is going on. But yeah, thank you. Back to you, Richard.
Thank you so much, Austin. We also have Ellie Vangala. She is currently in a class right now, so she is not able to introduce herself. She has been with the Student Success Center for about, what is it now, a year and a half? Her major is in English. I believe it's professional technical writing. She will be along with Austin and Guadalupe, as well as Nigel and Wyatt, are the friendly faces you will see up front, helping you out when it comes to what resources you need to find and all these other things. Okay, the last person that I just want to let you guys know about is Rulas Voru. She is the Associate Dean for Student Success and Academic Programs. Do you remember that major advisor I was telling you about? That's her. She is the person who oversees our center, as in addition to a few other centers like the Writing Center you may have heard about. You may see her around a little bit. She works in the dean's office as an administrative individual who manages various support offices in our college. So now we're going to jump into a little bit more about the topics involving advising, all these other things, to introduce and talk about how advising works at San Jose State, because not all universities do them the same way. I'm going to have Stephanie come back and talk about how advising works at San Jose State and how the College of HNA does advising.
All right. Hello, everyone, again. So I'm going to be talking about advising and how it works at San Jose State. So there are important things to know when it comes to advising at SJSU, and to know which advisors to seek help from when you need help in certain areas. So I want to focus your attention on the gray diagram. So these are offices that serve our special populations, such as EOP, or Educational Opportunity Program, athletics, and then Academic Advising and Retention Services, which supports our undeclared students. So if for some reason you ever do go as undeclared, that would be the center that you would go to. So those would service our special populations, and they just give more enhanced advising for those students. Now let's focus on the blue diagram. So this diagram shows major department advising. So you'll have a major advisor. Sometimes you'll have multiple major advisors, or sometimes you'll have a specific advisor for you. And so what they do is they provide major advising, course scheduling for major courses, and then anything related to the major for opportunities. So like internships, or just getting to know more about that major, your major advisors would be the people that you want to talk to. And they are faculty actually in the department that are also teachers, you know, that are going to be teaching you throughout your program. And so that's where you would go for major related questions. Now to focus on the gold diagram, that is the Student Success Center. So that's where we come into play. So our Student Success Center helps with general education and non-major advising. We can help with maybe if you need to know a little bit more about changing your major or what the process is, we can help you with that. If you need help interpreting policies and procedures, we can also help you with that. Course planning and related to GEs. And then when it comes down to when you're closer to graduating, we can make sure that you're meeting all the university requirements that you need in order to graduate. So these are kind of the different realms of advising. So just take note of how it works at San Jose State, because there are different places to go for different questions that you have or different populations that you are a part of. And just know that even though you are a part of a special population, does not mean that you can't utilize the Student Success Center. You can utilize the Student Success Center as well as the major advisors and as well as your student your specialized population. So Richard, go ahead and take it over.
Okay, thank you very much, Steph. So just to recap all that, you're gonna at least have two advisors. You're gonna have a major advisor as well as Student Success Center advisor throughout your time. You're gonna typically have one advisor for every single major or minor you might have. That's later down the road in terms of the details of who that's gonna be and when you're gonna meet them. Next, we're gonna talk about how our center, the HNA Student Success Center, supports you. We offer various programs such as the Peer Mentor Program, which Nigel and Wyatt are a part of. We also offer help with career exploration, trying to figure out how humanities and the arts fits in our 21st century technology-driven world, as well as the Bounce Back Program and ways to learn skills to help you out in the future and develop these skills in a manner that is positive and constructive for you. So the first topic we're going to go over right now is career exploration. I'm going to have.
All right. So I'm seeing some really awesome questions that you all are posting in the Q&A, and please keep it coming if any more questions pop up as we're going through. So one of the first programs and services I would like to introduce to you is our career exploration component. So as a career specialist, I work closely with our career liaison, career counselor Judy Garcia, to bring you services, events, and workshops to assist with your major in career exploration, networking, and job search and internship preparation. So we seek to address common questions such as, is this major right for me? What can I do with this major? How can I begin building skills and finding internships to jumpstart my career? So for connecting you with alumni to even reviewing your resume, we are here to support your career and professional development. And so your career journey to us is just as important as your academic progress. And so I definitely welcome you to stop by and connect with us anytime you're on campus or even virtually online. So right back to you, Richard.
Thank you, Sandy. The next particular service that we will be discussing is the Peer Mentor Program, and I'm going to have Lauren discuss that.
Our peer mentors are current SJSU Spartans that we've hired to share their own challenges and successes in navigating both academics and general life as a college student. Through our training, they have extensive knowledge about campus resources, academic departments, and student organizations. They are skilled at making appropriate referrals to our campus partners and other opportunities to enhance students' time at SJSU. Our peer mentor program enables our HNA students to gain access to knowledgeable and more experienced peers who can provide the important student perspective, insights, support, and most importantly, a sense of community at SJSU.
Thank you, Lauren. So that's the peer mentor program. Now to discuss the bounce back program, I'm going to ask Rania to tell you a little bit more about what that is.
Hi again. So yeah, we have a very special program, the Bounce Back Program, and it is a program designed for students who might find themselves, you know, not performing very well for whatever reason. It could be sometimes they have some personal circumstances that impact their academic performance. It could be other stressors coming from outside, but we have designed a comprehensive support strategies for when students find themselves facing academic difficulties through the Bounce Back Program. It is an online program, and it has three self-paced modules, Ready, Set, and Go. And within this program as well, students would be matched would be assigned to an academic advisor who's going to work closely with them throughout the semester to help them strategize and devise a personal success plan. This is in brief the Bounce Back Program. Thank you.
Thank you, Rania. So that's the Bounce Back Program. So to recap, that's career, the Peer Mentor Program, and the Bounce Back Program. Those are just three big ways. There's a lot of other smaller ways of how our center helps, either obviously or sometimes in the background. So now to talk about a little bit about resources for academic success, that's gonna be me. We're gonna be going over the four Mys. I call them the four Mys, but it's all called MyGPS. So the tools, the main four tools that will help you out in terms of planning your academic path here at San Jose State will be My Roadmap, My Progress, My Planner, and My Scheduler. So I'm going to talk a little bit about what those four are. So My Planner is an interactive online tool for undergraduate students to map their entire path to graduation. So you're going to see semester by semester, here's a chunk of classes you fill out. I'm going to take these semester, this the following semester. That's My Planner. And all of this is online, by the way. I should say that. My Roadmap is a recommended way of fulfilling all the classes within a four-year window. So all degrees at San Jose State fall within a 120 unit window. Some majors go a little bit, just a hair more than that, but all of the plans are designed to be finishable in 4 years. So what that basically means is you have My Planner, which is you planning out the individual classes you will take at what semester. My Roadmap is a recommended way presented by the university to ensure that you know when what requirements should be fulfilled at what time. The third one is My Progress. So My Progress is an online tool on MySJSU, which will tell you what all the requirements are for an entire major. And it'll tell you, okay, you have finished this requirement, but you have this one left, you have this one left, you have this one left. It will not tell you necessarily when to take it. It just tells you what you have done and what you still need to do and what you're doing right now, what classes you are taking to fulfill the requirements that you are in. My Scheduler is a little bit more zoomed in on the semester level. My Scheduler allows you to, based on a whole bunch of factors like what class you need, when it is offered, other extracurriculars that you might be participating in like work, sports or other family commitments, you create a schedule for you in the semester. So to recap one more time, my planner is semester by semester, taking all the classes in bulk, kind of making your own roadmap. My roadmap is a way, is a recommendation of where you should be at what time. My progress says when you my progress tells you where you are with all of your requirements in bulk. Doesn't tell you when necessarily. And my scheduler will help you semester by semester creating a scheduler. Whew. And that's just the four main ones. There are a lot of other smaller ones that we can help you figure out at San Jose State. There's a lot of small ones that can help specific cases or anything like that. But these are the four main ones. So I hope that helps you. If you have any questions about those, please go ahead and put your question in the Q&A. I know that that is a concern that many people have with the planning. So make sure that you ask those questions in the Q&A section. The next section that we are now going to talk about is about the center itself, including our hours, where we're located, and what we do. So I'm going to have Tamara introduce and talk a little bit about our center.
Okay, hello, welcome. Thank you for coming and sticking with us this afternoon. So I'd like to introduce you to our actual center where we are located. Currently we are all virtual, but hopefully when we all get back to campus, you will see that we are located in Clark Hall 244, which is across from the Olympic statues on the Tower Lawn. If you look at a map, you'll be able to see where that is. Currently, we are working remotely, but when the campus reopens, we will be available to meet with students Monday through Thursday, 9 to 5, and Fridays, 9 to 4. We do offer both drop-ins and scheduled appointments. Please check out our website for current updates and important information about advising within the College of Humanities and the Arts. You can see our website posted on this slide. And in the meantime, if you do have additional questions, you can go to sjsu.edu/HA advising, and you will find a link that will send an email to one of our HA advisors if you have any questions.
Thank you, Tamara. So that's a little bit about our center. Check out our website for up-to-date information on announcements and such. We'll be able to help you out. Okay. All right, so let's answer some of the questions that you guys have raised throughout our little presentation. We will probably give about, what do we have here? About maybe 10 to 15 minutes towards this. So we have a couple questions here and we'll just go and kind of nail them off the bat. So the first question is going to be for Rania. So Rania, this question is for you.
Yes.
What is the difference between peer connections and your organization, the Humanities and Arts Student Success Center?
All right. So peer connections is a very good resource. We often refer students to peer connections. It is a resource for all undergraduate students, no matter their major. They have tutoring. So you go for subject tutoring, and tutors there are trained and they're selectfully, they are carefully selected based on their, you know, high achievement in specific subjects and courses so that they can help you also with the study skills for specific subjects. They have workshops for students ranging from personal and well care to time management and study skills. They do also have a peer mentor program. And again, it is open to all the students. Our center have very similar services, but it is on a smaller scale and it is designed with our humanities and the arts students in mind. So when we think about workshops, we're thinking about how students study in the humanities and the arts, what kinds of projects do they have? And then we design these workshops around them and the services around them. And our peer mentors do a very similar job to the peer mentors in peer connections. They work closely with our students as well in helping them navigate our college and our environment within the larger university.
Sorry. Okay. So that's that question. Yes. One small thing to add, I, as a student myself who was here at, in 2012, Peer Connections also offers a wide variety of very general tutoring. So if you have any general math, and I'm not talking about like engineering or like very specific high level science kind of questions. If you have, let's say your general education question or your general history question or something like that, just need some tutoring, they provide that. We do not currently offer tutoring at our center. Some other centers do in terms of the college advising. So that's just another thing with that. Okay. Let's move on to another question. So Sandy, I'm going to ask you this question here. The question is, do we go to the Student Success Center for applying to minors or second majors, or do we talk to our major specific advisors?
That is a terrific question, and I am so glad you asked, because honestly, the answer is it depends. So it depends on the major, and it depends on the process in which that major requires. So for example, if you're considering something in the science or within engineering, they typically require that you attend a change of major workshop first. But then there are also other majors that require you to first meet with a major advisor. And what's really important to keep in mind if you are considering changing your major is you would have to apply to the major. There is no absolute guarantee that it will be approved. And so the first step is to check in to see if you need to start with a workshop or the major advisor. And then the second step is to figure out what the change of major requirements are, because there may be a certain GPA threshold that you need to meet, there may be certain classes that you have to take, and depending on how many classes and if there are sequences, it could potentially extend your graduation date. And so that's really important to keep in mind. If you're ever not sure about where to start or who to go, I would always recommend starting with the Student Success Center. Because if we're not the place you need to start with, we will be sure to refer you to the right place to go. And last thing I wanted to note is that if you are eligible to apply to the major, there is a change of major minor form involved. And so whether you are changing your major or minor or adding a major or minor, you'll need to complete a change of major minor form. And depending on whether you're under 90 units, above 90 units, there are different forms for that too. So the process can get a little confusing, so please stop by and speak with one of us if you're ever confused. So I hope I covered everything with that. Is there anything else that anybody would like to add? If not, right back to you, Richard.
Thank you. Thank you, Sandy. One small thing, every single major does and minor kind of does it a little bit differently, so you just might also want to double check with the department if they require anything before, if they require that you do a specific thing, as Sandy said. But it's not too much, it's not usually too difficult to try and add a specific major or anything like that. But there is a process, which what Sandy was talking about, the formal way of changing or adding or anything like that. Okay, we are zooming through these. Let us go to the next question. This one is for Lauren. Lauren, the question is, if we want to plan out our roadmap, do we go to the Student Success Center or the major department advisor?
That is a great question. And the answer is actually you will want to go to both when you're creating your own individual graduation plan. As Stephanie mentioned a little bit earlier, advising works differently at San Jose State than what you might be used to at high school. I know when I was in high school, I had one counselor that I went to about all of my questions. But at San Jose State, we have different areas of expertise. So when it comes to things specifically for your major, you'll be talking to your major advisors who are faculty members in your department. They're going to be most helpful with understanding the order in which you should be proceeding through your major classes, as well as the actual expected workloads of them. So you don't want to overwhelm yourself. our Student Success Center helps you with everything outside of the major. So some things, the categories are like general education, American institutions, physical education, and overall units, things that are common to all students regardless of major. So in your first 2 years, you're probably going to be seeing a lot of us and a little bit of your major advisor. So you should get connected with them early. And then you'll start focusing more on your major requirements in your third and your fourth year. And you'll come back to us to make sure that everything else outside of the major is taken care of too. So both places are good kind of people to connect with at least once every semester.
Okay. Thank you, Lauren. That's pretty much the gist. I don't have anything to add to that. Always double check early and often. It's always better to be proactive than reactive when it comes to course planning and figuring out what classes to take. So we have some time. That's kind of as it is with our Q&A. We do have a few other questions that might help you think along. Maybe you were thinking about it, but you weren't exactly sure how to phrase these questions. And so one of these things is, let's see here. Well, I'll answer this question actually. What classes do I take? That's a great question, Richard. What classes do you take really depends on where you are in your academic plan. And this goes for wherever, of course, you go. Wherever you are in your academic plan, how many classes you want to take, how many classes you know you can take and handle, because those are two different things. Just because you want to take more classes doesn't mean you necessarily can, especially if you're trying to balance things out. As we said before, there are the four documents at San Jose State. I'm actually going to go back just a bit to show you guys. Oh, that's not the right one. I want to go back just a bit here. These four tools, again, are the four main components to helping you figure out what classes you have left at San Jose State. Always double check with two humans, okay? Major advisor and a Success Center advisor. The Student Success Center advisor will help you out with everything that doesn't have to do with your GEs, and the major advisor will, surprisingly, I'm just kidding, will help you out with your major advising. So any class that has to do with your major, if you have a minor advisor, any class that has to do with your minor, these kind of things, these are the people you're going to be talking to in our college, okay? Typically what happens is it kind of depends on the major, just to give you an idea, is that a lot of people spend their first few semesters, especially if they're not really sure what major it is they want to go to, taking a bunch of GE, general education classes, which are the requirements that everyone has to take at San Jose State, in different departments, you know, to explore what it is you want to do. For me, I had no idea what I wanted to study. I came to San Jose State as an undeclared student. I took some linguistics classes, and I think this is more the exception than the rule, but all of a sudden I was thinking, oh, I know exactly what I want to do now. Well, not exactly what I want to do, but what I wanted to study. And so that's the best that I can recommend to you going into this. Don't feel pressured to know what you have to do and know what you have to take. That's part of the experience in learning more about yourself in college, because I don't know how many people left high school, are going to leave high school knowing what they want to do, or at least having the expectation that they're going to know when they get to college. That's what college is there for. Okay. So that's my little input on that particular question. Does anybody have anything to add onto what I talked about? Any fellow alumni? Okay, so let's move on to another question. And this question is for Stephanie. So Stephanie, the question is, what do academic advisors do? Do they only help with selecting classes?
All right, thanks, Richard. So what academic advisors do? So I kind of went over this a little bit in the diagram. So when we looked at the goal diagram, you know, advisors can help with course scheduling, But not only with course scheduling, I mean, for GEs, they can also help with referring you to resources. So let's say you just don't know where to go to get help with tutoring and you need to know where to go. Advisors will be able to tell you, you need to go to Peer Connections or you need to go to this center that has tutoring. And so we can help you with referrals. Again, you know, when Rania talked about, you know, the BBP program and helping you, students who maybe need that little bit of a push, we're always there to help those students. And so it's not just advising and saying, these are the classes you need. We do a lot of different things. We want to be there for the students. And so, you know, just an overall helping students with classes, helping students just navigate the university, and getting accustomed to everything that comes with starting college, we're here to help. And so that's basically how we're here to help you as academic advisors.
Okay, thank you very much, Steph. So that's the gist of it. So that's kind of an idea about what we do. We're kind of the Swiss Army knives, I like to think of our college. We do a lot of stuff that may not be seen on the surface, but also a lot of it is seen on the surface. And you'll see us running around doing things that you probably didn't expect academic advisors doing, but that's a surprise for you to discover for another day. Another question here is, this is for Lauren. Lauren, the question is it possible to change your major on the first day?
So as Sandy kind of alluded to earlier in the question about changing or adding majors and minors, more than likely most departments have at least one set of criteria that you need to meet in order to become eligible to apply. So it's rather unlikely that you could officially change your major on your record the first day of college. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't start talking to the advisors for what you're intending to pursue to start adjusting your planning and your course enrollment to help you work towards that goal. So again, some classes might be required by a major. They might need to have a certain GPA or grades in them, or a certain number of units that you have to earn in order to apply. So the answer is it depends, but more than likely, you're going to probably have to wait a little bit, at least one semester or two, to officially change.
Okay. Thank you, Lauren, for that. It's a question a lot of students have. And it's good that we have an understanding when we first start. Okay. So the next question, we're going to wrap up the Q&A. We have another about 8 minutes here. We'll be taking maybe about two or three more questions. The question is, and this question is for Darlene. Darlene, the question is, will the tutoring, mentoring, and advising services be offered even if classes are online in case classes on campus don't resume in the fall?
Yes, we are open as long as the campus is open, whether that's in person or virtual. So we will continue to find ways to adapt and we will continually improve and refine our processes. Started off a little rough, but we are getting there and I feel like we're starting to get our rhythm and we'll just continue to do that. So yes, we will absolutely be available to support you regardless of whether or not we are in person or online.
Thank you, Darlene. So let's go with maybe, we have about two more questions here. Let's go with Tamara. Tamara, this question is for you, and it's just more a general kind of question. The question is, what opportunities are available to enhance my college experience? Are there any sort of student organizations or anything like that that can help me out?
Yeah, that's a great question. And actually, there's a whole Greek society on campus. Usually within the first, I think, 2 weeks of school. I don't know how it's going to be in the fall, but all the Greeks clubs are on campus trying to recruit students. So that's a real good way to socially connect with other students, and they could be from a variety of majors. And there's also organizations related to special programs. You know, accounting and business majors have a club. design students have a club. So there's a lot of on-campus clubs related to majors. And for professional organizations, there's also ways to connect with faculty members who have contacts. And a lot of times students will do internships while they're attending San Jose State. And that's a good way to professionally connect and find out if that's the right career for you and to meet with people. So when you graduate, you'll have a lot of job opportunities. So I think once campus gets going in the fall, you'll see that there will be constant emails sent out about different opportunities of connecting to other students and other faculty, depending on what your interest is. And Career Center also offers a lot of resources as well.
Okay, yeah, thank you very much, Tamara. So there's a lot of stuff is going to be coming your way in the next few semesters. So you're going to be able to find those. We have time for one more question. And this one is going to go to all of our student assistants. So Nigel, Austin, Wyatt, and Ellie. The question is, and we'll start with Nigel. Okay. I'll key you guys in. Nigel, the question is, what should I expect in my first year? And maybe share a brief memory or two about what you remember in your first year.
Thanks, Richard. Hi, this is Nigel. What you can really expect in your first year, from my experience, was a large transition. A lot of it comes mentally as well as physically. Your eating habits will change, as well as your organization habits, your sleep habits, everything that you kind of have as a structure that you may have had at home. This is more specifically being a student that lives on campus or is moving to the area, as I moved from Southern California to the Bay Area to attend San Jose State. It will definitely impact you in both ways. And it can be kind of tough at times, especially if you don't feel like you have as much of a social circle as you did back at home, because having those connections really helps you transition. So in your first year, there will be a lot of change is the biggest thing that you'll experience. On top of that, you'll be learning and exploring a lot of new topics in just the general education experience and the core GE experience that you'll have as the beginning first 2 years. You'll be taking just necessary core GE requirements to satisfy those. And then eventually you'll start moving towards more major specific classes. But in the beginning, you'll really just be in a big period of transition, trying to find a space that you can call home. And that would be at least what my experience was when I first started at San Jose State for my first year.
Okay, Austin, could you be so kind as to share a little bit of your insight involving your first year?
So this is only my second year at San Jose State. My first year, I got to live on campus, which was really cool. And I recommend it if you could. I agree with Nigel that it's a pretty big transition and there's a lot to get used to. I was originally from Fairfield, which is only about an hour and 10 minutes away. But still being that distance from my family and still trying to get used to living by myself and handling school and, you got to take care of yourself. It was definitely different, but it was also, I think it's a privilege getting that experience. So, if you're planning to live in the dorms, definitely just find your own kind of way of dealing and managing your time and stuff like that. And definitely just try to get out there. That's going to be your way of connecting with people, with similar likes and traits and stuff like that. And there's also a lot of free stuff on campus, which I like too. And make sure to have shower slippers if you're planning to live on campus. All right, that's enough.
Okay, thanks, Austin. Let's have Ellie provide maybe a brief tip.
So my first year, I was thrown a lot of like confusing information about all these like GE requirements, and it's a lot to keep track of, especially in your first semester, these A4, B4 things. And that's why you have your advisors who really tell you what these mean. I just took a class because my advisor told me to take the class. and I still don't know what Math 8 stands for, but one thing I did know was my limits, and I should not have taken it at 7:30. So I think it's really about knowing at what time you succeed and what times work for you, because like 4 years later, that's the only class I got a C in, and that's because I can't do math at 7:30, and I should have known better. So I just think time yourself better and know your limits.
Thank you, Ellie. And last, but certainly far from least, why you want to wrap up the student perspective and give a few tips in your memory in your first year?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Richard. First year is kind of like a, you know, it's like everyone before me has already said, it's a really big change. And you may come to find that it is like the most laissez-faire time that you've ever experienced. And if you don't know what that means, it's pretty much like a hands-off kind of thing. You know, like how Nigel said, you know, it's a big change, and you know, both mentally and physically, you know. So, I mean, no one's going to be telling you what to eat, you know, and unless you go to like advisors, no one necessarily is going to be telling you to do class, you know, certain classes. You know, that's all you. And if you don't manage it, you know, then it can be a lot. And you'll have to learn very quickly how to manage that. I mean, for example, in my first year, I decided right off the bat in the first month, I was going to go and try and work 20 hours a week while doing 17 units. Not a good idea as a freshman. Let me just throw that out there. That was a lot. I quit the job after 2 months because I nearly failed every class. And then I had to pull it back up in probably a month and a half. And that was some rough work. So that's kind of be my biggest tip. Also just be flexible. This will be quick, you know. You might find that you need to go in a completely different direction than what you initially expected. I had signed up for 6 GE classes, and then I discovered that as a music major, I had to take major classes from the first semester, and that was a huge change. Had to completely rearrange my entire schedule. And so not that's going to happen to everybody, but just be flexible. Keep an open mind. Try not to bite off more than you can chew. You know, add small pieces at a time, because, you know, you never know when you're going to kind of like reach that needle that breaks the camel's back. Just try and get through everything with a nice level head and make good decisions.
Thank you, Wyatt.
Sure.
So the last part that we are going to discuss now, I'm going to bring Darlene, our director, back. She has some tips that she'd like to discuss with you all before we wrap up here today to help you succeed, not just your time at San Jose State, but also in the future.
Thanks, Richard. Yes, so there are so many tips and suggestions that we wanted to give you, but these are the top 5 that we all feel are the most important and the message that we want you to hear as freshmen. So tip number 1, ask questions sooner than later. There really aren't any dumb questions. In fact, you can rest assured that a lot of the questions you probably think about but don't ask, someone else is probably doing the same thing. So do yourself and your new friend a favor, just ask the questions. College is a time to explore. You are not expected to know the answers, so just ask. Tip number 2, learn about and utilize campus resources. SJSU has so much to offer, and one of the best ways to facilitate a fun and stable adventure is to take advantage of everything that this campus has to offer. So you can only do that if you know about them. So I challenge you to make the first year, make it a point in this first year to learn as much as you can about what we have to offer. You will not regret it. Tip number 3, build a supportive network. Humans are social animals. We are not meant to do this thing called life alone. We understand that. And the people that you surround yourself with can make a huge impact on your experience as well as your ability to succeed. So be open and, you know, be willing to connect with others. Tip number 4, create a study space for yourself. We've had to learn very quickly how to work online and in a virtual environment, and it was really challenging. So one thing that this has taught a lot of us is your space, your workspace, whatever it is you're doing, it's really important. So we notice that we perform a lot better when we're intentional about the space that we create. And so as a student, we highly encourage you to create a very comfortable workspace for you to study and work on your projects, okay? And just a quick life hack. You heard it here first. Ironing boards make great height adjustable workstations. They can get pretty expensive when you buy an actual workstation that's adjustable, but ironing boards work really well. And the last tip, this is probably my favorite, stay present. Life only happens in the here and now. And everything else, whether it's a past, something in the past, or a worry about the future, those are just thoughts, okay? College can be quite an adventure, and getting lost in your thoughts might make you miss out on a lot of the good stuff. So if you start to struggle, just reach out. We are here to support you. So those are the five tips for freshmen. Thank you again so much for joining us today. It has been an honor and a pleasure to share this virtual space with you. I hope you enjoy the rest of your afternoon, as well as tomorrow's events for SJSU's virtual open house. Tomorrow they're going to focus on next steps in the admissions process. So I wish you the best of luck in wherever you may go, but we really hope to see you here in the fall. Have a beautiful day, and thank you again for joining us.